Controversy tonight generated by the change in leadership at the city's animal care and control facility. The new director, Spencer Moore, has become a lightning rod for animal rights groups and animal rescue operations. RTV6 reporter Jack Reinhart joins us live tonight from our downtown studio with more on this.
Well, Erica, Spencer Moore has been on the job a little more than 3 days, and that's just long enough to get reacquainted with how animal rights groups are protective of their animals. Spencer Moore, appointed only this week as acting director, has drawn out the critics of animal care and control. Animal rights organizations and rescue groups have expressed concerns that only days into the job, Moore has overstepped his authority as a temporary replacement, making changes that will negatively impact the live release rate and the euthanasia of animals.
We're just hearing a lot of concerning reports from a variety of people, people on the city county council, former administrators, variety of staff, people at the shelter. The concerns are that maybe the progress that's being made might be starting in the opposite direction.
Animal Care and Control takes in more than 16,000 animals annually. Over the past couple of years, the shelter has made big strides in increasing the live release rate of animals and modernizing the fleet and equipment. Moore, who once ran Animal Care and Control for 9 years, says he's not looking to change existing policies but streamline the system.
For anyone to think that I'm going to come in there and change that and to take it away or do anything, that's something I worked so very hard to get done anyway when I was there 15, 20 years ago. They don't know me.
In 1999, Moore was recognized by the Public Safety Board for reducing the euthanasia rate by 17%, for increasing adoptions by 400%, and for increasing the live releases of animals by 150%. Deputy Director of Public Safety, Valerie Washington.
We're quite disappointed, especially to hear rumblings from folks that we've partnered with in the past. And I would say even more disappointing that we haven't received actual phone calls from any of them expressing their concerns directly.
Spencer Moore told me that his door is always open, and he too has expressed frustration that the groups who have raised concerns about his leadership style haven't picked up a phone to call him and tell him that. Reporting live downtown, Jack Reinhart, RTV6.